All right, New Brunswick Hoop fans, are you ready? It's the NBAA Final 12, live from TD Station here in St. John. I'm Dave Tingley on the call for you here all weekend from TD Station, and we're kicking you off with what's going to be a good one. The St. Malachy Saints in both AAA Finals. First, the girls team looking to finish some unfinished business from last year, looking to make their mark and win their first provincial championship. And the Harrison Trimble Trojans coming off a miracle comeback last week against the number one ranked KV Crusaders in their own gym, down 22 in the first, coming all the way back to upset the highly ranked Crusaders and get here trying to win for the first time in 27 years. The Trojans and the Saints. Here we go, tip off in St. John. And the tip, won by the Trojans. Audrey Gaylord on the control now. Up top is Kate Fillmore. She's gonna run things all night here from the point for the Trojans, the senior. Off to Gaylord, she's gonna pop a three, and that's what she does well. She doesn't go, and down with the rebound is Clancy McIntyre. That's not gonna be the first time I say that. The senior looking to finish off a stellar career with a championship, and a three from the wing there from Grace Collins is no good. Trojans clear. Fillmore looks like a zone here, 2-3 zone for St. Max to start. Allison LeBlanc now on the wing. She gets it to Gaylord, she's gonna pop that. Yeah, that's too wide open, can't give her that. She back rims it though, and the rebound controlled by by Allison LeBlanc. And a turnover up top by the Saints. Back come the Trojans. Gaylord now, she turns it over. Clancy McIntyre, she's gonna drive in with the left, too strong. Tap to the corner nicely by Jenna Higgins, kept alive briefly. Out of bounds, it's gonna be a jump ball, and Kate Fillmore knocked over all kinds of chairs over there in the corner, but luckily, that's the most damage that was done. She pops right back up. Takes a lot more than that to get Kate Fillmore out of the game, I promise you. McIntyre now up top. Her twin brother playing later tonight in the guys' final. And a turn and a spin, and the first two goes to Eva Knobloch. The German exchange student. And now with the turnover, it's back in Eva Knobloch's hand. She gets to McIntyre. She's gonna pop one from the wing. Back rims it, and a rebound though, down to Higgins, back to McIntyre. McIntyre, not a lot of movement here, a little stagnant possession from the Saints. And that's a wide left shot from Knobloch from the top there, the grade 11. Scored the first 2 points of the game. Comes up empty on that one, and now Fillmore back here against that 2-3 zone. Awaiting the Trojans. Inside, back out to Fillmore. She's gonna pop a three. It's long and rebounded there by Knobloch. She's gonna push. Spins in the lane, back outside. Collins now. Allison LeBlanc surveying things. Another senior for these Saints, trying to erase the memory of a disappointing 3-point loss last year. Physical defense inside there by Jill Campbell, what she does best, pushing McIntyre off her spot, and that's a turnover on the high pass. Skip pass to Gaylord, she attacks the closeout. Tries to get it back inside. Wide there for Allison LeBlanc. LeBlanc, she's gonna be playing rugby next year for Santa FX and studying kinesiology, but right now, she's trying to bring the Trojans their first championship in 27 years. Knobloch controls the long outlet from Higgins. It's 4 points for her and nothing for the Trojans, and another turnover. Pressure out top, and now Collins with a deep three and a 7-0 burst to start here from the veteran Saints. And now can they get it in? They can't. Trojans turn it over again. They're fourth here early. And Coach Jared Budd over there just telling them to settle down, not using a timeout. A lot of coaches would. He trusts his players. Clearly. Giving them a thumbs up, saying don't worry. It's St. Max. This is how they succeeded last weekend in their semifinal win over the Royals. Put a lot of pressure on the Royals in the backcourt. Coach Danny Patterson said, we made them make decisions. Obviously made some wrong ones, and so have the Trojans so far here to start the final. Oh, Clancy McIntyre collects and scores inside. 9-0 now here for St. Max's start, and that pressure is up again. Can't get the ball into Fillmore. She's being face guarded by Allison LeBlanc. They've decided Fillmore's not going to be the one to hurt him. Good drive inside, though. Then a miss from Jill Campbell. And collected there by Ella Smith. She's going to go to the line for two free throws. A little traffic in front of me. I couldn't quite see the action there, fans. So thanks for joining us. Fans, finally a little break in the action here for some free throws from Ella Smith. Third year playing varsity basketball. Real strong student, says Coach Jared Budd. Solid defender and rebounder. And she, her role's expanded as the year's gone on for the Trojans. And she breaks the schneid. Crooked numbers on the board now for Harrison Trimble. They're putting pressure on up front as well. And they create a turnover. Gaylord now, she controls things, didn't pick it up cleanly. Smith into the corner now. That's going to be a three, and that's long from Campbell. But it's going to stay with the Trojans. Good hustle there from Savannah Berry. One of the great 11s on this team. Trimble set up for success this year and going forward. Got some youth and some veterans on this team. Fillmore surveying, man-to-man here. Oh, and a nice baseline drive. She gets all the way, and the nifty finish on the other side from Jenna Higgins. Not an easy one. And a quick 4-0 burst and another turnover. Anything you can do, we can do better, says the Trojans. You pressure us, we pressure you. And right back in it here is Trimble and the faith shown in his players from Coach Jared Budd. Back to the zone now here for St. Max. They're going to give up another wide open one. Boy, they're going to pay for that at some point. Gaylord's going to get one of those to go. She's 0-for-3 to start, but if I'm Coach Budd, I'm saying, clapping my hands and saying, great shot, keep putting them up. Into the game for the Saints now. Lauren Graves and Anna Keach. Pardon me. Ava Mason and Ashley Bro. I'm looking at the wrong roster, fans. I have not seen a lot of these girls this year. So bear with me while I make my mistakes. So Ava Mason and Ashley Bro in. Mason, she fumbles it, but nice hands there from LeBlanc fighting to get it back. It went to Knobloch, came right back to her, and now stepping into a shot there is Bro. She's wide right, but a nice nifty pass back inside to Knobloch. Mason there, the senior, collected that miss and found a cutting Knobloch, and she's got some points early. Does Eva, 11-4 here now. Man-to-man again for St. Max's. They mix defenses. Another nice baseline move. This time, Clancy McIntyre came over. Looked like she got a lot of ball there. But going to the line for two more free throws is Ella Smith. So thanks again, fans, for joining us here on AO for these for this Final 12. Is a timeout now for the Trojans. So our thanks to the gold sponsors here for the Final 12, BrokerLink Insurance, University of New Brunswick, Rocket Printing, Hilton, St. John, and the silver sponsors, Royal LePage Atlantic, Domino's, and Subway. Whew. So, fans, a big start, a frantic start here a little bit. Both teams coming up in full court pressure, trying to turn the other team over, and both having some success. St. Max was able to score early and so get into their pressure earlier than the Trojans were. They scored the first seven, or pardon me, the first nine, and then the Trojans came back with four unanswered before Max stretched the lead back out to seven. But talked to Coach Jared Budd a lot, an old buddy of mine, a fellow Riverview High grad, which is why I'm trying hard to be partial here, St. Max fans, but you took out our my alumni there last week in a minor upset in Riverview's gym, but I'll try not to hold that against you. And Coach Danny Patterson, also a friend and a good ref. I didn't put italics on that, I promise, Danny. I didn't put anything on that. That was absolutely, fully 100% me. I wasn't paid money to say it. But no, good friends and coaching staff on both sides. Kim Sinclair, one of the driving forces behind the Maritime Women's League here in the Moncton franchise. She's an assistant for Jared Budd, so two more at the line for Ella Smith. The lead back down to five, and St. Max has had success twice getting it over the top. Clancy McIntyre fumbled that first initial catch, but got it back, and now popping a three that was long there was Ava Mason, but rebounded nicely by Allison LeBlanc. LeBlanc now tries to step through, gets her own rebound, fumbled, out of bounds, is going to stay with St. Max. So St. Max beating that pressure a little bit from Trimble over the top. Trimble's trying to rely on a lot of pressure from their guards that they can, led by Kate Fillmore, and they can do that, but if they don't get enough pressure, that pass over the top's been there a couple times. Clancy McIntyre back rim. Good box out there, this time from Smith. Fillmore now surveys the landscape, gets it over to Savannah Berry. Berry, nice pass inside for a cutting Campbell. She's not able to finish, but she's able to get her hands on it and tie up McIntyre, and it's going to stay with the Trojans. Good hustle play there from Campbell. One of those other great 11s that coach and staff calls a Swiss Army knife, and I'd agree with them. She can do a little bit of everything, Ken Campbell. There's Fillmore popping a three. Gets the good roll, claps her hands as that one goes through and brings that lead down to two. And another turnover here from Max as they can't collect that ball out of bounds. Good denial there from Ana Palacios Thompson, a grade 9 player, new onto the floor for the Trojans. So like I said, blend of experience and youth. So now back to that zone look from St. Max, but I'm not sure. Fillmore, I'm not sure that look, whether they dropping it out of one pass or even fooling me. And I'm sitting here in the commentator's chair. Fillmore missed that back rim, that three. Ashley Bro faked it, and then turnover Max. And now the Trojans, after a rough start, have a chance to tie or take the lead here. 3:14 clock running first quarter. Skip pass up to Savannah Berry. Savannah Berry finds Campbell inside. Campbell with the nice kick and the three. And that lead that I talked about is the Trojans. Ella Smith off to a hot start. Seven early for the Trojans. She steps in there on that pass. Wasn't able to pick it off. And there's Fillmore for the second time flying into the St. Max bench. She's had more action in those chairs than the St. Max starters have, as Kate Fillmore. Would you expect anything less from Kate? No. Going to Mount A next year, my alma mater, and where I currently assistant coach. So nice drive there from Clancy McIntyre. Not going to get to the line. Foul early. First foul on Ellis Smith. Campbell, good physical defense there with McIntyre, blocking that cut through the lane. St. Max was trying hard to get it to her on that inbounds. Campbell was having none of it. Now they switch off that inbounds, and Palacios Thompson's now going to deal with her. Good defense from her and forces the miss from McIntyre. Fillmore comes in and snags that rebound, hits it up to Palacios Thompson, almost loses it, but a nice save from Campbell back to Fillmore. Fillmore, oh boy. Savannah Berry Hit it right in the numbers, but she fumbled her out of bounds. Back to St. Max. So not a tremendously high scoring quarter, but it's been exciting to watch early with the style of play really matching up well. Both these teams looking to pressure. There's Clancy McIntyre again on the wing. This time she gets it to go, and Max takes that lead back. And this time Trimble breaks that press over the top. Fillmore looked like she might have got a little contact there. No call. Back comes St. Max. Knobloch off to Bro. Tried the banker and missed. Miss collected by Savannah Berry, and Trimble now walks it back up the floor against that zone. They've done a good job against that zone. Trimble, once when they've beaten that press, haven't gotten any of those threes to go yet there. However, as long on the three that time was Savannah Berry. Knobloch's going to look to go again. She gets over, dribbles there, and Fillmore comes away from the pack with it. On the wing, it's Berry. She tries to go inside to Campbell. Nicely done there by Jenna Higgins, dropping and taking that pass away. Clancy looking to set a screen out top. Now she gets it to her at the high post. Lots of cutters. Well done there by Higgins. And a good find from Clancy McIntyre. One of the all-stars. And she is a, I forget what they call it, Southwest. Yes, Southwest. And Northeast. I always get those screwed up. So the Southwest All-Stars. Clancy McIntyre was named onto that team, along with Grace Lenihan and Ella Simmons from Leo Hayes, Ava Sprague from Fredericton High, and Megan Schedule from Kennebecasis Valley. Two for two at the line is Higgins. Lead back to three now for St. Max. Again, Trimble having a tough time getting that ball in. But nicely done there from Campbell to Fillmore as we head under a minute now. First quarter here. Triple A final on the girls' side. Fillmore can't get it to go. Feels like there was contact again. No call. Back comes McIntyre. Nice. Oh, almost stolen there. And now they are going to get the turnover. A good step in there from Peyton Dunn. You onto the floor for the Trojans, along with number seven, Abby Assels. Youth, both grade 10s. So, as we said, Trimble, a mix of experience and youth. There's Assels from the baseline. Oh, back, nice looking shot, but back rimmed it. And a rebound there from LeBlanc. Again, they go to the high post to McIntyre. Again, they've got cutters. Nothing there this time. But turned her back to Assels on. She turned her back, and sometimes they can get into trouble. And there's Gwen Shannon, new onto the floor, and she bangs it through. And now at the buzzer, Fillmore almost gets it to go. And Max ends a strong defensive first quarter with a 17-12 lead. And you see on that replay, yeah, you definitely want to pay attention to Clancy McIntyre at that high post, but you turn your back on your man, and she's going to make you pay because she's not afraid to share the ball with her teammates. And she shared the ball there with Gwen Shannon. And Gwen Shannon banged it through. Shannon, a grade 11, plays softball and volleyball for St. Max. I got to give a shout-out to the coaches. Thanks to the coaches for both of these teams for getting me some info on them. Like I say, I haven't seen the teams play all that much this year. St. Max's is my first time seeing them at all. Actually, no, I saw them at the Girls' Hoop Classic, pardon me, but they were a little shorthanded there. So myself, I'm an assistant coach for the guys' team at Mount Allison, so my time is spent in the gym with that team. Normally, I'd see a lot more of the high school level action, but I didn't this year, so I relied on the coaches for a lot of info, and they helped me out. So Danny Patterson, actually it wasn't Danny. I shouldn't give any props to Danny. Danny didn't do anything. It was all Julia Rance. That's who I got the email from. I'm betting it's Julia. Julia and Jocelyn Wells are his assistants. And a shout out, I gave a shout out to Kim Sinclair, but also Aaron Smith, the other assistant for Harrison Trimble. Like we said, fans, Harrison Trimble won one provincial championship in the girls' side 27 years ago, 1997. 96-97 season. St. Mac's has never won one. They came within 3 points last year in this setting. Disappointing ending for them. They were the favorites going in. And they got upset. So they are all business this year, and they have come out firing. 17-12 lead. Trimble, though, got off to a 9-0, had a 9-0 deficit and fought back. So good on them. It could have been a avalanche here early, but they have stayed the course. But there's McIntyre. A girl that size can beat you off the bounce. Oh, and a tough defense there from Eva Knobloch, too. And they're going to keep the – yeah, that's a good call. Good overrule. He overruled himself. Pointed the wrong way. But Eva Knobloch's been impressive so far, both offensively and her toughness defensively. You see what a difficult matchup Clancy McIntyre is. Tallest player on the floor, and she can put that ball down off the bounce and beat you and find teammates. Speaking of finding teammates, nicely done there. Kate Fillmore dropping it off for Assels, who banks it in. Assels, a great 10. She's really made offensive strides this year, says Coach Jared Budd, to be effective on that end. She comes ready-made defensively, though. Again, Trimble's had a tough time securing that rebound to finish possessions here on the defensive end. Gonna have to improve that. That might be a second one on Ella Smith. It is. That's a problem if you're a Trojans fan. Audra Gaylord's going to come back in, the senior wing. As we talked about, Max played with fire there early with her. She's made the most threes on this Trimble squad, but 0 for 3 from distance so far. A couple of them real wide open ones, so you got to figure she's going to get off the Schneid sooner or later. Peyton Dunn there, good pressure up top on the turnover, but right back by Jenna Higgins, and she gets to McIntyre. McIntyre knew that was a miss before it even got to the top of its arc. She was already putting her hands to her face. But luckily, again, LeBlanc came in, and a good cut there from McIntyre. And a good find there to Knobloch. And Knobloch makes it. The ball movement from St. Max in close quarters. Solid. And then beating that press is Fillmore. She's going to drive all the way. Doesn't get a call. And it's right back to St. Max. A little frustrating there for Fillmore. She's had some opportunities in the lane, but good physical defense without fouling there from St. Max. Caused a miss, and another nice cut, but good hands there from Assels to disrupt that pass from McIntyre. She was looking for Bro that time. And a wing three again from Gaylord, not in, but Assels physical in there. Oh, and a nice move from Fillmore and a pull-up. Doesn't get the roll this time. And Shannon in there to collect. Higgins now stops and pops and gets the roll. Pushes that lead back to 9. And the Trojans are going to need one. Another timeout. Harrison Trimble's, they go back 9. The St. Malachy Saints have equaled their biggest lead of the game so far. 7:43 on the clock here. Again, sometimes it's just a make or miss thing, and right now, Max is making the most of their opportunities. And Harrison Trimble hasn't seen much go through the iron there for them so far in the half court. They've gotten some open looks, haven't made them, but they were down 22, a similar point in the game last weekend to the number one ranked team in the province. So if you think they're gonna rattle them, I've got news for you. It's been quite a year for the Trojans. By his own admission, he had mixed expectations to Jared Budd coming into the year because they had just graduated seven seniors. But on the other hand, five of the six returning players were in the rotation last year and two starters. So they still had experience and leadership to draw on. And so, you know, midpoint, the team was still finding itself, he says, but the results were sort of middling, but they struggled with their consistency. But they, as the year went on, they kind of went, okay, I think we got a little higher ceiling than we expected. Started to believe themselves a little bit. And look where a little belief will get you. To TD Station and a chance at the provincial championship. You can hear Coach Jared Budd against this press urging Kate to go get that ball. Go get it, Kate. Kate Fillmore. She's going to drive again this time. Oh, not for sure that was going to go down. No, but she does earn a trip to the line this time. And that's going to be the second on Grace Collins. First one goes down for Fillmore, so we'll reset it here. We've got Peyton Dunn, Fillmore, Audrey Gaylord, Abby Assels, and Jill Campbell, the five for the Trojans. Campbell in there mixing it up. Earned another jump ball. Second time she's done that off a miss. Earned her team another possession. So Eva Knobloch, by the way, I know I was calling Ashley Bro Eva Knobloch there for a minute, fans. Again, I haven't seen them. I'm going to make a mistake or two. So my apologies to friends and family of Miss Bro. So Knobloch back on the floor now for the Saints with McIntyre, who has the ball. She's going to pop one and goes. She's got a nice stroke. You can't leave her alone. That's what makes her so scary. You got to get up on her, but then she'll blow by you off the bounce. It's a pick your poison situation with McIntyre. And a good 45 look there from Assels, but a little wild there to Gaylord, and this lead is now 10. Double figures for the first time for St. Max. So resetting the lineups for Max. It's McIntyre and Knobloch, Ava Mason, Jenna Higgins, and Grace Collins on the floor with her two for St. Max. A little inside-out action from St. Max. Back to McIntyre. She's going to go on the left, attacking Campbell. Well done from Campbell. Ball comes back to Collins. She can pop that, and she makes it again. Second one from deep for Grace Collins. That lead now 13. Getting into dangerous territory for these Trojans. You got to figure two big comebacks back-to-back weeks against teams is good. Not an easy task. And a wild pass there inside from Dunn to Campbell. She's not able to collect. And another turnover and now a foul on Assels. That's going to be the second of the quarter here on the Trojans. Checking back in is Knobloch. Allison LeBlanc, pardon me, from, it's going to be Mason. No, it's going to be Jenna Higgins. Higgins graduating this year, going to UMB Fredericton. Also a very talented soccer player. Lots of two sports stars in the lineups for these teams and in subsequent teams this weekend, I'm sure. Nifty there from Knobloch. Oh, boy, that's a difficult one. Little Steph Curry-ness stewer there. Eva. Pretty. The Berlin, Germany native. Fancy stuff. There's another pop from the top. From Gaylord can't get her shot going. Someone's going to need to provide some scoring here, punch for the Trojans at some point. Confident looking shot there from Collins. Didn't go and done. Well done chasing it down in the corner for the Trojans. Fillmore now. She's going to try another one. You got to figure the laws of numbers. Faraji, you're going to kick it at some point. Finally, she gets one to go and the lead's down to a dozen. Picking it up at the top there was LeBlanc. She was able to get it to Collins. Collins watched closely there by Assels. Now screen. She rejects it. Goes back to McIntyre. McIntyre now. She's going to go. Steps into a long two. Back rim. Good box out there from Fillmore. Boy, that looked like maybe an over-the-top call was in order. Didn't get it. Second opportunity for Max. Doesn't go. And Gaylord collects. Fillmore now. Done. Wide open for another three. Can she get it to go? No. Comes up short, but she almost chases down the rebound. So Max was asleep there a little bit. Now McIntyre. She's going to try to step through and get it a finger roll to go. No good. But fighting there for the rebound was Ava Mason. Grade 12, creating a tie-up situation and keeping the ball with St. Max. Dunn and Assels check out. Back in are Smith and Savannah Berry for the Trojans. McIntyre comes to the ball and gets it. Faces up on Campbell, picks it up. Higgins. Good pressure there out top. Trying to create another turnover, can't do it. Against the clock, though, they're going to have to get one up, and it is going to be a turnover. The solid D there from the Trojans. Play call here from Jared Butt. A little different look. Four people right across the top. A horns look, I think, is what he was calling for there. It gets him a wide open look at the key, and that is great execution there. Campbell finds herself free at the foul line. One step in, easy shot over the front of the rim, and that lead is back down to 10. And the Trojan fans, who travel well and have filled a couple of sections here at TD Station, getting raucous. So All-Star Game, as you can hear the announcer over the TD Station here talking about tomorrow, the All-Star Games on Sunday, pardon me, in Ross A. So fans, stay tuned all weekend. If you don't know what the schedule is, go to the NBIA website. But after we crown a champion here tonight, they're going to match up later at 9 p.m. on the boys' side, an all-St. John matchup. We almost had two St. Malachy's KV matchups this weekend. The Trojans girls spoiled that with a big comeback, but all St. John later, the Saints and the Crusaders. That'll be a fun one here at 9 o'clock here on AO Broadcasting. And tomorrow the schedule kicks off at 1 p.m. with the A girls final, Southern Vic and Harvey High School. The single A boys, John Caldwell and Sam DeSham, trying to become the first Francophone school to win a provincial championship. St. Stephen High and Ross St. Netherwood in the AA girls at 6 o'clock, and 8:30, Funday High, and École Saint-Anne. Also trying to become one of the first, maybe the second in the same day, Francophone school to win a provincial championship. So exciting stuff here tomorrow. So another turnover forced by that Trimble defense. Now they can bring it back down into single digits. Gaylord doesn't like her options. Dribbles it back. Savannah Berry now collects. She has to get one up against the buzzer, and a turnover right back. Stellar defense from the Saints, forcing a turnover. Shot clock violation. So different pressure here, different look from the Trojans. St. Max beats that one as well by getting it long. Back up top to Collins. She's going to pop it. She's got a quick release there too. Not able to get it to go. McIntyre saved it. Everybody stopped playing there. Not Fillmore. She pushes. Good defense there though from Higgins, cutting her off. Oh, but a nice look inside. Yeah, and Smith traveled, but Fillmore brought it back and then reattacked and found Smith, but Smith kind of an awkward catch. She was off balance when she caught it. Wasn't really able to get her footing and traveled. And here comes the Trojan is in the building now. The Trojan fans react. Clancy McIntyre now. Oh, and a nice cut inside. Not able to collect, though. And smart play there by Fillmore to let it go out of bounds. McIntyre found a cutting LeBlanc. A lot of mustard behind it, but LeBlanc asked her. She'll be the first to tell you that she should have hung on to that one. Another turnover. It's gone back and forth here, the turnovers, since that last time out. Ooh, and a good close out there by Collins to block, and then another turnover. Gaylord had her shot blocked, and then Smith had it taken away. Oh, and a pretty cut by Eva Knobloch. And a dime drop there from LeBlanc, and the lead's back to 12. Fillmore comes and gets it. UConn's the call from, that looks like a high screen. Oh, and she finds a wide open Smith. Smith, though, back rims it. Rebounded, though, nicely from Barry. Barry to Gaylord. She can attack off the bounce, too, and she does. Gets it in the lane. Oh, just off the back rim. And a rebound from Collins. She gets it. She's going to pop that one. That's an automatic for her. That's like a layup. A wide open wing three from Grace Collins. Forget about it. And the lead swells to 15 again, just when the Trojans think they've got it back down to a manageable deficit. St. Max puts on another push. Do they have a push in this last minute 15? Oh, and a turnover there again from Trimble. Can't take care of the ball. And the St. Malachy Saints are making them pay. That leads 17 now. McIntyre screams, let's go, as she heads to the bench. She's put her team up 17 here with a minute 4 left on the clock in the first half from TD Station, AAA Girls Final. Thanks again, fans, for joining us. Dave Tingley here on the call, taking a night off from coaching to be your friendly neighborhood host. And a good matchup here between a couple of teams that don't have a rich history as far as winning this game goes, as we've mentioned a couple times. St. Malachy's, a school of about 700 in the heart of St. John. Started in 1958 as an all-boys Catholic school. Switched over to 82 to co-ed. And some of my Harrison Trimble friends like to brag about Sidney Crosby being an alumni of their school, which, you know, come on now. They like to claim them, but I don't think you can beat. I think St. Max has you beat. You might not recognize the name off the top of your head, fans. Lyman Ward. You might not recognize that name. But he was in 3 episodes of Murder, She Wrote. He was in 1 episode of Sweet Life of Zack and Cody, but you might know him best as Tom Bueller, Ferris Bueller's dad. Ferris Bueller's Day Off. Sorry, Trimble fans. St. Max wins the alumni competition, because they also have Jonathan Huberdeau. So they got a professional hockey player, and they got Ferris's dad. Back to the important stuff. Fillmore drives, and it's blocked by Clancy McIntyre. Is having herself a half, and then even worse news for the Trojans. There's Ella Smith's third foul, as she shoves McIntyre in the back after the rebound. Only the third foul of the quarter on the Trojans. The Trojans haven't committed a lot of fouls, but half of them have been by Miss Smith, and she's got to go to the bench. That's a big call. And now St. Max here has a chance to stretch it out even more, and a nice-looking jumper from Eva Knobloch, who's been terrific in this first half for the Saints, and that lead is 19. Trimble wants a hoop and a stop here to end that first half to give themselves a little bit of good feeling going into the half, and Fillmore just can't get that hook to go over the bigger inside presence of the Saints, and they're gonna look to push, and there she is again! Knobloch ahead of the field, just outrunning everybody. Now only 6 seconds left in the half. Fillmore, I don't know if she knows. Yeah, now she does. She's going to get it up at the buzzer, in and out. There's the story of the first half for the Trojans as they go into the break. Stuck 21 here to the hometown Saints, looking to erase memories of a heartbreaking defeat last year in this building by three, and they have done their job in earnest in the first half as have the Saints jumping out to a 21-point lead. So well done. We're going to set up for an exciting second half if the Trojans can write the same script they did last week and come back from a big 22-point deficit, but they got a lot of work ahead of them. We'll see you back here, fans, in 9.5.
In this video tutorial, by going down to the overlay section in the bottom right, so you'll see Stinger input, so from channel. So we can do that by going down to the overlay section in the bottom right hand corner.
And we're back, fans. Sorry, didn't little delay for me to start the second half. And a turnover from the Trojans to start. So we'll reset you here. So it's a 41-20 St. Malachy's lead. And I was going to say that was the story of the first half was turnovers. And Trimble's got to fix that if they have any hope here. But they come right out and turn it right back over to the Saints. McIntyre, 10 points in the first half and a turnover for Max. Good poke away there from Fillmore, and she's got to be the one that goes and gets that ball and takes care of it and sets people up to for success here in the second half. 3-0 in and out from the wing there for Savannah Berry, and a couple of those have to go for the Trojans to have any hope as well. Only a couple threes in the first half, one from Smith, one from their leader Gaylord in that category. So two turnovers, though, in two possessions for St. Max. So Trimble, defense engaged. They need to score a little bit if they're going to come back. This needs to be a high scoring half for the Trojans. Only 20 in the first. Had to be at least 15 turnovers for the Trojans in that first half. Had to be at least that number. Fillmore now penetrates. Gets it up through a lot of hands and can't get it to go. And first half star Eva Knobloch pulls it down for St. Max on the wing there. Up for three and the soft rims can't go for Collins. Almost her fourth three. She had nine in the first half. Three threes accounted for all of her scoring. But empty trips for St. Max, but no success in the other end for Trimble cutting into this lead. They got to come up with a recipe against the St. Max zone. They did a good job. After they got down early, they did a pretty good job getting it right there to that foul line. Boom. Man, I'm a good commentator, right, fans? I called it. Jill Campbell nailed that foul line jumper, and that's going to be a turnover. Yeah, that's a good no call. That ball was a 50-50 ball, and Ella Smith almost got her fourth. But that was just good defense. She got all ball there. Good kick to the 45. To Gaylord. She didn't like the three. Back to her. Feet set that time. No, she attacks the closeout. There's McIntyre changing minds with her size there in the middle. Gaylord's got to keep going. Attack McIntyre. Get into her body. Into the body of that shot blocker. Maybe you get to the line here, and that's how you get the get some more numbers up on that board. Again, they got to force up one against the clock late, and that's a turnover. Back to St. Max, and here comes McIntyre. almost another turnover. Coming to meet it, though, nicely was Knobloch. 14 points in the first half for her. Another nice cut. But again, physical without fouling. Ella Smith. They've decided to, I mean, really, there's no tomorrow. What are you going to do? What are you saving her for? Oh, a nice pass inside to Collins. McIntyre. When she's not scoring, she's able to set people up. That was nicely done from McIntyre. Grace Collins, these two have played together for a long time, both graduating. She knows how to play with McIntyre. She knows she moves without the ball. Clancy will find her. Grace, studying nursing next year. Misses two, but there's McIntyre. He gets taken away by Gaylord, but right back. Boy, the ball bouncing fast and furious. I can't even account for all the action in those quick 2 or 3 seconds. McIntyre, they'll go right back to her spot, but again, well done there from Smith to play without fouling and create a miss from McIntyre. They find Fillmore. 2-0 is all the scoring that we've had in this quarter. And short there was Campbell, but again, a rebound from Fillmore and a bank three. There's no pictures on the score sheet. Gaylord doesn't care. That's her second three. And another turnover. And two more quick ones from Barry. And as quick as you like, it's down to 14 here at TD Station. These Trojans try to create another one. And they do. Fillmore. And then she gets hit. A good foul there from Higgins. But scattered play here from the Saints. Collins checks out. In comes Ashley Bro. But a nice little run here for the Trojans. 7-0 to start the third quarter, just what the doctor ordered. And less than 4 minutes in, that lead's come down from 21 to 14. And they got the ball back. Trying to cut into that lead a little bit more. Fillmore retreats and attacks and finds her again. Long this time, though, was Gaylord. But also almost a steal, and she does, and then she gets pushed in the back, and that might be unsportsmanlike, and yes, it is. So that's going to be two in the ball for the Trojans. That's a good call. A bad turnover and then a push. It wasn't really a dirty play, but a two-hand push in the back in that scenario. She wasn't trying to injure her by any means. It was Ashley Bro, but it doesn't matter. A two-hand push like that in the back, that's going to get called intentional every time. We'll see if Fillmore can take advantage. She makes the first and the second. And that leads down to 12 now, and the Trojans with the ball. You can't do this 2 weeks in a row, can you, Harrison Trimble? They're right back into it, though, and these fans have woken up. That's going to be a wing three to nail that lead down to single digits. No good. And there's McIntyre. Nicely executed play, though. Just didn't get it to go and banked in from Allison LeBlanc. That's kind of an awkward-looking runner, but she shot it with confidence and it went in. LeBlanc playing rugby at X next year. You can tell she is a rugged player. Physical defensively. She's made life tough on Kate Fillmore so far, and she finished that one at that end too. Off to McIntyre. McIntyre operates out of that spot really well, and she finds another cutter. Jenna Higgins and Trimble consistently getting caught with their back turn, watching McIntyre at that high post. You gotta know where she is, but you gotta see the ball and your man. It's no good. And a turnover. And Max has turned up the heat after a rough stretch. Higgins finds Wells. She lays it up and in for two. And that lead right back to 18. Trimble beats the press. Fillmore's got two on two, but she slows up goes to shoot the three, and it gets knocked away by McIntyre. What an athletic play by Clancy. Fillmore tries to take it right back, but no can do. McIntyre, though, turns it back over. Fillmore pushes on Knobloch. Oh, and a good find for a long three. Oh, back rimmed. Again, an open one for Gaylord. Can't get it to go. Trimble, though, second opportunity. Another wing three, and down it goes. Savannah Berry buries one from the wing. Cuts into that lead again, down to 15. Trimble's not going to give up. 4:05 left on the clock. Trimble's making it a game. So again, thanks to our gold sponsors, BrokerLink Insurance, University of New Brunswick, Rocket Printing, Hilton St. John, and the silver sponsors, Royal LePage Atlantic, Domino's, and Subway. Couldn't put on an event like this without the sponsors, and this event, high quality as always. And I'm not just saying that because they got yours truly as their announcer. I gave up a coaching gig for the night. Fans, I coach at Mount Allison on the guys' side. We got a game in about 25 minutes. Half an hour down the road, 45 minutes down the road in Fredericton. So I'm here watching future Mount Allison Mountie Kate Fillmore and her squad take on St. Max. St. Max had a rough stretch there to start the third quarter, then had a burst and then gave up another little quick burst back from the Trojans. So Danny Patterson wanted to have a little chat, maybe make an adjustment here to their, both teams have had a lot of trouble breaking pressure. Yeah, they're giving a little bit of a different look here to their press break. Seeing if they can handle this pressure a little bit easier than they have been. Trimble, though, well, that's not going to get there. Yeah, Kate Fillmore is going to break that up every time. I don't care how tall Clancy is. Oh, and Gaylord couldn't quite handle that pass, and it's turned back over. So now Max has a chance to push. That's a smart play, though, by LeBlanc. Pulls it back out. That's going to be a wing three. Looked good, but bounced away from by Wells and rebounded by Trimble. Here's another push. Look at that kick ahead pass. Oh, that's pretty as you like, but she can't finish. On the wing there, can Ella Smith off a gorgeous feed from Savannah Berry, and another turnover from St. Max. They're doing whatever they can to keep Harrison Trimble in this game. Oh boy, they're gonna get Clancy McIntyre. Looked to me like maybe she had Gaylord pinned there, moving her feet well, but giving that one to McIntyre, that's her second, only her second. Still in good shape, so the bench coming in for Trimble. That's Peyton Dunn and Abby Assels, the two grade, pardon me, I said grade, Peyton Dunn was in grade 10, excuse me, she's in grade 11. She's been on this team though for 3 years, since grade 9. Fillmore now, calling Assels up for a screen. Oh, look at that pass, Assels just quite can't collect it. Boy, that was a nice pass, and Fillmore getting on the floor, trying to keep things alive, but it'll be a whistle, it'll be a St. Malachy's possession. Boy, that pass. I think Assels probably didn't think that was gonna be coming to her and slowed up a little bit. If she'd have been at top speed, that probably would have been a two, would have been a layup done there. A little too much air under that pass from Higgins. Dunn came over and knocked it away. 17 on the clock for St. Max. The ball into Wells. Wells looking for McIntyre. McIntyre on a turnaround. Good box out there from the Trojans, but the bad bounce came right to Eva Knobloch. She was able to lay it in for two more. Knobloch's terrific evening continues. She's been the best player on the floor tonight. Maybe a tie with McIntyre. A lot of fouls here early for St. Max, and now late the Trojans are going to have a chance to go to the line, claw this back a little bit. Only one team foul in the quarter with 2:33 left on the clock for the Trojans. So they have the advantage here in the last 2.5 minutes. If they can get some stops, get to the line a bit with the clock stopped, that would be a recipe for climbing back into things. We'll see, and they've been solid at the line so far of the Trojans. Peyton Dunn goes 2 for 2. They're going to stay with that pressure, so back to 15. McIntyre is going to take a break. Probably the last 2.5, she'll stay out. Trojans want to keep that pressure on. Almost turn it over, boy. They could afford to take a couple of risks here, though, late. Only, like I say, only one. That's only their second. Still got two more to give before anybody's going to the line. So you can take a couple chances here. Down 15, trying to create some turnovers. There's Barry riding the hip of Wells. She gets it up. Again, the bounces go the way of the Saints. Knobloch kind of awkwardly didn't know what to do with it. Just kind of handed it to Wells. Sharing a laugh, and Wells is going to go to the line. First. Doesn't get the roll on the first one, does Wells. She plays soccer, field hockey, and volleyball for St. Max. So, 4-sports star. Well, it's only in grade 11. She'll be back next year. Ahead of the pack is done. If they'll find her, they do. So, she's got one-on-one against, and that's going to be a, that's a really good call. Higgins did her best. Ooh, what are the Oscars? They're coming up soon. Trying to give Jenna an award for that one. Went down like she was shot. Trying to take the charge, but no, that's a really good call. Was nowhere near in guarding position, and Dunn's going to have it. On the senior Higgins. Peyton Dunn at the line. Made a couple of big threes sectional weekend. Did Peyton Dunn. Pardon me, P. Diddy or P. Money. I don't know, fans. I don't know who I'm going to go with. That's her nicknames. And they sound, you know, they just roll off my tongue, as you can tell. P. Diddy, P. Money. And she's been money from the line, has done. 4 for 4 here the last couple trips. Leads down to 13. Now, St. Max having a little issue here with the clock. Nope, they get it over. And now they've got numbers, but turning it over almost, or does she? Almost. Did Lauren Wells, but the arrow luckily is with St. Max. But the arrow is important in the girls' game. There's more tie-ups in the girls' game than the guys, so you got to keep that arrow is important as it gets into the fourth quarter. A miss on the wing, but a crash there from Wells, and she misses a layup, gets it back, misses another one, and Dunn's in there to rip it away. But ripping it away from her was Knobloch, and then you got two more. Boy, that was a scrum in there. A couple of these kids playing rugby next year. Blanc was mixing it up in there, the ex-NFX rugby player. But the Trojans, again, with the arrow, get it back. And now back in that 2-3 zone is St. Max. They've mixed and matched these defenses tonight. Trimble's done a pretty good job finding things at the high post. They haven't had as much success with that three-pointer. Assels has done a really good job mixing it up down there on the glass in her minutes. Anna Palacios Thompson back in for the Trojans, the grade 9 player. Makes a nice pass inside, on, not able to connect with Campbell though, and another turnover in the push. And a nice block, beautifully done by Campbell. She gets back. Gets a hand on a pass and then gets a block, and Fillmore driving hard inside. Takes some abuse, and she's going to go to the line for 2 free throws. Campbell, one of these grade 11s, hustle, all the hustle work there from her. She's just a connector. her coach calls her. And that's a real good description for the type of player. It's commonly used in hoops nowadays, a connect. Offense looks better. Defense is more solid. She just connects everybody together with her diversified talents on the floor. And she gets a hand on that and turned over. And Dunn's going to get a chance to go to the rim. She misses, though. Clancy McIntyre collects that rebound. Up to Shannon. Shannon slows things down. Collects it. And there's a wing three from Wells. Wide. Run down there nicely by LeBlanc, who got it back to McIntyre, who got it back to Shannon, and Shannon turns and fires and gets hit, and she's going to go to the line now, both teams. How this last minute goes have largely done their job. If you'd have told them you're going to cut this lead in half going to the fourth quarter, they'd have taken it. Shannon, though, trying to push this lead out to 13. Once again, with almost exactly a minute to go, she doesn't. And the rebound in there by Assels. Campbell and now Fillmore on the run. Nice drive there from Thompson. She finds Assels in the key. Back rims it though, can't finish. And here comes McIntyre and the Saints. Can they end this third quarter in another burst? Push the lead back out a little bit more. She finds LeBlanc. LeBlanc fires, no good. But again, another wide, wild three. And they're gonna have to throw one up against the clock, and it's Wells, and she finds the bottom from deep. What a big one that is for St. Max. The lead goes from a dozen to 15. Inside 10 now. Dunn's gonna run something. Finds Assels, back out to Campbell. Campbell had an open three, didn't take it. Now she's going to have Fillmore with 4 seconds. Fillmore's going to have to force a three, and she does. It's wide left. And the Trojans, after all that good work to bring it down to 10, pardon me, 11, now got to go to that fourth quarter break, stuck 15. But hope prevails if you're a Trojans fan. And if you're a St. Max fan, you got to feel awfully good about the situation you're in, but you don't want to take anything for granted. Tough loss in this building last year. You know the team across from you came back from almost the exact same deficit. Girls team in the driver's seat for a provincial championship. They got the guys team coming up next, trying to make it a double in this building tonight. But the Trojans are going to have something to say in this fourth quarter, I have a funny feeling. Fillmore now watching LeBlanc to start this fourth quarter. High post to Shannon. Finds McIntyre. Good ball movement from the Saints, and McIntyre is going to pop one from the corner. Doesn't go. Dunn watches it go out of bounds after she hit the box out. So to start this fourth quarter, it's Palacios, Thompson, and Dunn, and Fillmore, and Campbell, and Smith for the Trojans. We'll reset the Saints here in a second. Palacios Thompson almost turns it over. No, gets it to Dunn. Dunn to Fillmore. Fillmore, nice cross-court look to Smith. She's going to pop a three. Just a little bit short, and watching it go out of bounds there is Shannon. So it's Clancy McIntyre, Gwen Shannon. Ashley Bro, Allison LeBlanc, and Ava Mason, the five to start the fourth quarter for the Saints. Mason gets it in, right back to Bro, and she hands it off to LeBlanc. Good press break there from the Saints, and a wide open look for McIntyre, but she goes off the side of the rim, and now pushing the pace is Campbell, getting it knocked away right at the rim, though, by Mason. The grade 12, Mason, studying sciences at UNB next year. McIntyre, she's going to take a break, and in comes Collins. Fillmore gets into the lane. Oh, looking for Campbell. Gets knocked away. Gets it right back. Spins and fires. Comes up empty and knocked out of bounds by Ella Smith. On this team for 4 years has been Kate Fillmore, heart and soul of this team. So says her coach, and so says anybody that watches this Trimble team play. Pull up there is long from Ashley Bro. Again, a slow start to this quarter now for both teams. No scoring. Minute and a half in. Trojans, they can't play back and forth with the Saints in this quarter. They need to have a big scoring quarter here to the Trojans. Now late in the clock, three in the key is the call. Campbell camped out in there expecting a foul. Peyton Dunn saying she's oh, knocked down from Campbell, creating the turnover. Back to Barry, looking for Fillmore, finds her. Campbell now inside to Smith. Smith's going to try to take it up. She does. She misses. Campbell crashing, can't collect. Collins can, and now St. Max clears. Collins, a good kick ahead pass to Bro. Bro on the pull up, can't bank it in. Good box out there from Fillmore. Again, the bounce though comes back to the Saints, but they can't get that one to go either. Pushing the pace. Looks like she got hit there, did Barry, but no call. Oh, and a nice, that's a nice shot from the wing from Peyton Dunn. She's got to take that, but she's long with it. Fillmore attracted the crowd and got it to Peyton Dunn. They just haven't gotten those perimeter shots to go, have the Trojans tonight at all. A little bit of a different story for Max. They've found the range from three a little bit. Collins has three of them. Now they're going to have to put one up here late. And against the clock and wide right was Ashley Bro. So again, Trojans not giving them up much on the defensive end, but they are not transitioning to getting anything going on the offensive end. And it's going to be a timeout here. Jared Budd and the Trojans. Harrison Trimble, a school of about 1,300 kids that opened in 1961 in Moncton. And a shout out to being a Riverview Royal. The school spirit at Harrison Trimble has always annoyed me, but you got to hand it to Trimble. Their fans have traveled tonight and a pretty big bunch to come here and see their team play. And it's not just a sporting events thing. They prove their mettle in on the school spirit side and the giving back side every year to this Harrison Trimble. The Trojan Trek's always a big event. They've raised hundreds of thousands of dollars for the neonatal unit at the Moncton Hospital. Have the students and administration at Harrison Trimble for the last several years. So yeah, when you attend a Harrison Trimble game, it's the rare occasion when you're out-cheered and out-school-spirited by the Trojans. Now tonight in their hometown, the Max fans got to hand it to them. They've showed up in droves here, which you have to expect, but Tribble fans are going to stay loud. They're going to hear the support from this crew or the girls if they can get this lead shrunk a little bit. You got to figure, you get this under 10, in the next couple of minutes, you start putting a little pressure maybe on St. Max. And getting inside there nicely was, oh, and ripped away by Campbell. Nice job by her. Off the miss from Barry. Now St. Max broke that press nicely. Matt, Tribble doing a good job of speeding them up too. If I'm St. Max, I get that ball over half. I want to put that under my arm for a bit. Oh, and Collins. Oh, the quick trigger from the wing for Grace. And by the grace of Collins, they go back up by 16. Do the Saints. Boy, she is automatic from that spot. Four threes tonight for Grace. And another three, all in and out. And there's your difference tonight so far. At one end, those threes are going at the other end, in and out by Smith. Pretty looking release by her, and now a turnover by St. Max. Coach Danny Patterson just urges his team to relax. Yeah, there's no need for that long cross-court pass at that point. Just back it out, be station to station with it, be patient. Only thing you can do to let Trimble back in is turn that ball over. And a three from the wing again, just can't get it to go. Can Gaylord, he's had lots of looks, just can't get him to go. All good shots from her tonight. Stepping in there, trying to break up that pass is Audrey, and you see her look at the ceiling like, my goodness, where's my shot tonight? She's made a couple. One of them was a banker, but she's had about six or seven more open looks that just haven't gone. Just all good shots, just can't get them to go. And a nice move baseline and a teardrop from Eva Knobloch. If I'm picking player of the game, I'm picking Knobloch. She's been tremendous since the opening tip. Hustle plays. Oh, and a pretty pass inside. Oh, can't get it to go. Kenella Smith, but that feed from Fillmore, my goodness. The table setter to the grade 11. So solid future here for the Trimble Trojans, whether they get it done here in the last 5:26 with a big comeback or not. Talked about they turned over seven grade 12s last year, four more this year, but the strong players just keep on coming. It's Campbell, Barry, Palacios, Thompson. They all come back next year along with a host of others, and two turnovers back-to-back for St. Max. Two more chances for Trimble. Oh, going baseline there was Barry. She had an opening, didn't take it. Now Collins with the steal and banged it off of Smith's foot out of bounds. You have to set the clock here, yeah. Is it 21? It's gonna impact the Saints trying to get it over half here. Yeah, so they've got it, they're gonna have five more seconds to get it over half. Oh boy, it's gonna be tough now. Nope, looks like they're gonna break it. They have to take some chances here. The Trojans late. McIntyre gets it out to Collins. Oh boy, she was locked and loaded there, but the pass was kind of at her feet. McIntyre, nice pass and a good fake inside. Pretty from Allison LeBlanc. The shot fake off the nice left-handed feed from McIntyre. She's gonna have a chance to stretch this lead up to 18. Under 5 minutes on the clock, and St. Max starting to smell it. Such disappointment last year in this building, a 3-point loss. Oh, and a fight down there from Knobloch, but she knocked it out of bounds, so it's a 17-point lead. 4:47 on the clock. Fillmore saving a couple of precious seconds here. Now Gets it into the middle against that zone. Nice move from Smith. Boy, if they could have done that more consistently all night. But St. Max did a good job on a lot of these positions. When they were able to get it to the middle and soften them up, they were able to kind of force that a lot of times with their size, with McIntyre down there, Knobloch, force that kick-out pass to the wings, and Trimble not consistently able to knock it down. Two free throws there knocked down, so back to 15, but Trimble hasn't gotten it much closer than this in a while. They need to turn them over a couple times right now. Get this down under 10. Force a miss, but there's a rebound inside. Jenna Higgins off the LeBlanc miss. The grade 12 sneaking in. Now she's going to go to the line for two more free throws. So 59-44, 4:25 on the clock. ...60-44 now. So last year, Miramichi Valley broke their hearts in this building with a three-point win. Now, as we approach the four-minute mark of the fourth quarter, and another turnover from Trimble and St. Max. You don't see any smiles or any fist pumps or anybody taking anything for granted just yet. But they see. Few possessions, and look at that. McIntyre bangs it and keeps it alive and run down on the corner, and then she's on the feet inside to Bro. Bro can't finish though, but she gets her own rebound again. The offensive glass is going to be something that they look back on, the Trojans, with regret as well, because the Saints have dominated the glass on both ends. Offensively have created a lot of second chances. But the Trojans have scrapped and clawed their way to remain into this game, and it's still not put to bed yet, if you're a Max fan. That, though, does put that lead to a dozen. Minute 25 left, and Fillmore's got to push that ball. The pace has to be pushed now. They got to get up shots and get them up quick. It's taking too long to develop. There you go. Smith looking to drive. Back up to Campbell. Too much time off the clock. Smith's going to pop one, and it goes for three. Back to nine. Minute four remaining. Now, can they break this press intelligently? They do here now. LeBlanc, solid work by her. Gets it to McIntyre. Backdoor feed. You don't need it. It's too quick. Fillmore gets it and pushes. Campbell ahead of the pack. Spins, expects someone to be out at the three-point line. Boy, you can see the dejection in her eyes when she released that pass and realized nobody was there. She had Bro backpedaling, and boy, that could be the play that breaks things. If there was someone there for a wide open three, this lead could have been down to six, but a turnover back to the Saints. And now St. Malachy's has a chance to ice this game, you would think. 44 seconds left. Trimble can't afford to guard for 24 seconds here. So you gotta figure that's gonna be there's gonna be a quick foul here. And with four fouls, Ella Smith, you don't want her to be the one committing it if you can help it. So 44 seconds left. Yeah, Trimble's going to be fouling quick, and they're going to be talking about ways to get themselves a quick shot up as well. I would imagine St. Max, their recipe isn't going to change. They've had success turning them over with a little bit of pressure, but sitting back in that zone. Has worked here too, so St. Max is going to line it up. It's going to pretty much be a... Oh, there's McIntyre setting the screen for somebody to go long. But now they've got a trap here. If they cannot foul, they can stay away from fouling. They get it away and they get it to McIntyre. Now they do for the lay-in. Clancy puts him up by 11. And that'll just about wrap it up. Trojans have got to push that ball and get a quick couple of threes. And no, they turn it right back to the Saints. And now, if you're a Saints fan, I think you can breathe. Point loss to the Pulumu from Miramichi Valley. And now this veteran squad with all these seniors, that's going to be a turnover back to the Trojans, but 18 seconds left. They're going to extend this pressure again. So all this waiting for a first provincial championship on the girls' side. 365-ish days as Fillmore misses that lefty layup out of bounds. Going to stay with the Trojans. 11 seconds on the clock. And the St. Max fans ready to explode. The bench ready to run onto the floor. It's a good feeling when you know the provincial championship is yours. I had this feeling once. I can tell you how good it feels. And St. Max, they've got possession. They can dribble it out. They're going to get fouled, though. 2.8 left. One of those seniors, Allison LeBlanc, is going to go back to the line. And the smiles on the faces of the Saints are coming through. Clancy McIntyre, the grade 12 All-Star, had a terrific game. Grace Collins with her four threes. Grade 12, terrific game. Sue Kochiet, grade 12, exchange student from Istanbul, Turkey. She's graduating and going post-secondary here in Canada. Allison LeBlanc going to St. FX and playing rugby at the line here for the second shot. Jenna Higgins, that's your grade 12s. That's your seniors for the St. Max girls. They've waited a year to get back here. The ball's out of bounds, 2.1. The celebration just keeps getting pushed out. They just got to get it in bounds. There it is. And that shot's blocked and the buzzer goes. And after a year-long wait and a lot of heartbreak last year, Danny Patterson and his coaching staff embracing the sidelines as that senior-laden squad embraces it midcourt. And your 2023-24 provincial champions for the first time in school history, the St. Malachy's Saints bring home a chip, and the tears are flowing on the sidelines of the Saints. Leading scorer and player of the game, in my opinion, Eva Knobloch finished with 18, Clancy McIntyre 15, Grace Collins those four threes for 12 points. And you gotta give credit to a game fighting, battling Harrison Trimble Trojan squad as the tears flow for different reasons on their end. They'll be back, but they'll be without four tremendous seniors. Kate Fillmore, Grace Lewis, Audrey Gaylord, and Kenzie Lynch. Bid goodbye to a program, but they'll be back. You might see these Trojans back here as soon again as next year. Maybe they're in position to rebound off a loss here at TD Station with a win. But this year, 2023-24, it's the Saints. Your champs. That was a fun one, fans. So I'll give over the duties to the public address announcer for the ceremonies here, the players of the game, and the presentation of the banner. And you'll see me back here at the top of the hour for the boys' final between the Malachy's Saints and the Kennebecasis Valley Crusaders as they present player of the game to number 8, Jill Campbell. Good choice, and I'm hoping. Yeah, I love that choice. Eva Knobloch, the grade 11. All right, fans, I've been satisfied with the players of the game. Now I'm going to check out, and I'll see you at the top of the hour.
Trimble High School, please come forward to hand out the silver medals to his team members. Number 1, Peyton Dunn. Number 2, Kenzie Lynch. Number 3, Gracie Lewis. Number 4, Audrey Gaylord. Number 5, Lauren Graves. Number 6, Savannah Berry. Number 7, Abby Assel.